Sandler. So fall tonight.
Yeah.
Right? First off, you guys, you get Gogowski, is what I like to call it. Right? And back to back, you guys get Gogowski,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And those dudes are just grindy, like PA dudes. Indiana guys.
Yeah, I wrestled one in the semis at Midwest, and it was a tough match.
Right? They're grindy dudes.
They're so.
Now he's down a little.
Crazy, yeah.
Right? Yeah.
Like, he was big for 41, I thought.
Okay, so now he's down. You guys get beat back to back by them, and you got to answer.
Yeah. Yeah. My coach looked at me because we wrestled Indianapolis, I think it was 3 or 4 weeks ago, and we just got hammered. Because all of us just came out flat, and it was the first two matches we just lost really close. And then he was like, "You got to take control right now. You got to get a big win." And I was like, "All right, all right." So I just went out and I wrestled super tough. First couple periods, I was like, "I can't really get it on a shot." But when I got on top and I felt I got that Steber bar on him, I was like, "I'm just gonna run this over."
So you come out and you do, right? You get the fall. You're pretty excited. Then Spielman follows up with he had a banana split, didn't he?
Yeah,
he had a banana split. So you guys are rolling at that point. Then you get bogged. That's literally how these guys wrestle, right? Yeah, they're just grindy and scrappy.
They just win in the little areas, and they're just gritty and tough. They're tough dudes.
But then, you know, you guys, Romanza, he's an NCAA champ. He shows you why.
Yeah, and that match was a lot closer at Midwest, and he just kind of picked that kid apart a little bit, which I'm sure they'll wrestle again. But that kid's a tough kid, too. Romanza, he's a national champ. He's going to be
right? So 74 overtime. Your guy stops wrestling the last 3 minutes. Yeah. I don't know what he was doing.
Yeah.
He's dominating, but you know, you guys down the stretch though, you kind of outlasted him in some matches. And 184, I think your 184 could be a star.
He's a freshman, state champ. He's a tough dude, and I knew when he came in, I was like, this kid seems like a tough guy. He's not going to give up much. He just goes at it with all of our best guys in the room, and he's going to be good. He's going to be one of the top guys in D2.
So when I go to D1s, it's always like, guys from the smaller programs almost melt when they wrestle the Big Ten guys. D2's not like that.
Yeah.
I love it. Anybody, I look at the brackets and I go to, I've only been to one of them. I went to 2014 with Notre Dame College, one here in Cleveland.
Yeah.
But like, anyone can win. There's so much parity. How awesome is that when you show up knowing that, hey, I don't have to worry about wrestling, you know, St. Cloud's got a good team, right?
Yeah.
Notre Dame's got a great team.
Yeah.
But knowing you can win the bracket.
You can win any match in Division II. Anybody can beat anybody. It's crazy. Anybody, if you get third at regionals this year, you have just as good a chance as a guy who got first at regionals to win a national title. I saw it last year. Some guy got fourth at regionals, and we don't even have fourth to make it anymore.
Yeah, it's not three now, right?
Yeah, now he's going to make it to nationals.
So you guys had 20% of the national champs last year, right?
Yeah, we had Craver.
Yeah, Craver and Randick, right? What's it like wrestling on a team with guys like that that show you the way?
It's really cool because, like, even though Kramer left, you just get to see them work every single day, and they are shouting us out and they're trying to make us better, but they kind of show you the way and put you into a different perspective of like, you have to wrestle this way to every single time you go out there, or else it's not going to be a win, and you have to get better every single day. And it was really cool because honestly, I never really thought I could win a national title until probably I was a sophomore in college, when I realized I made it to nationals as a freshman, and I was like, woo, and then I just crapped out, went 0-2, and then my sophomore year, I was like, I can win this. I didn't end up placing, but I was right there with everybody else, just like everybody in D2.
You won the toughest in-season D2 tournament this year.
Yeah, I would say it's probably the toughest.
No, I'm saying, I'm saying, you don't need to agree with me, but you know, you won that tournament. Did that give you some confidence?
For sure it did. I mean, I didn't come off it very well. I lost my next match after that, but it definitely, I know I can beat anybody, because the guy I beat in the finals, he was ranked second in the nation. I don't know what he is now, but I know that he probably should be up there, and I've taken my lump this year for sure, lost to a guy who wasn't ranked, and now I'm back down, but it's time to turn it up now. All I got is regionals left. This was my last duel tonight, and it's time to go.
You're a junior, right?
Yeah.
Right, so you got one more year left.
Yes, sir.
All right, you got anything else for me?
Nope.
Good luck. I'm going to try and be there in Cleveland. Hope you'll be up on the stage wrestling. And thanks for the time.
All right. Go Eagles.